Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Here's our yeast bread dough after it has risen for 1 hour and 15 minutes. And I think that's all it needs. I did have it in a warm place and it rose very nicely. And you can see that the plastic is sticking to it, but it will peel off very nicely because of the spray that we put on there. And now, if you watched my mother's dinner rolls video, you know my favorite part is coming up, and that's punching down the dough. So here you can take some frustration on the dough if you want to. So I'm going to just make a fist and go right in the center and punch it really hard because we want it to sort of collapse. Here it goes.
Ooh.
Yeah, I was taking my frustrations out on Rick and he felt it. But now what this does is sit and rest for 15 minutes, and I'll come back and show you what we do to make the loaves. Here's what our yeast bread dough looks like after it has rested for 15 minutes. Actually, I think we let it go a little longer than that. It has come back almost to the point where it was because that yeast is active and it's doing its work. What you do is take your cover off. And then what you want to do is divide it into two equal portions. And those portions are going to be loaves of bread. And you might use different techniques for getting halves. This looks so symmetrically shaped, I think I would maybe make myself a mark. Actually, if you can cut through this, that will probably help to keep the two halves equal. It doesn't matter if you compress the dough, you can squeeze it as much as you want. I'm just trying to get them equal, and that's why I decided to use the knife and cut them right down the middle. But just pull out one half of it and form that into a loaf. And anything that is not pretty, I put on the bottom. So it doesn't really matter too much. But it is kind of nice if we can get that straightened out. That'll make even the bottom look pretty too. Now I'm going to put this in my loaf pan, and I have two loaf pans waiting here. They have been buttered. I've just taken butter and rubbed it along the sides and the bottom. These are each 9 by 5 by 3. That's the standard loaf size pan for a standard loaf of bread. So we're just going to place this in here. And if I have made it too short, then I'll just pat it out until it goes to the corners. So I'll be doing the same thing with the other half. And each one of them is going to get its piece of plastic wrap that has been sprayed. I'm trying to see which side has been sprayed. It's this one right here. Actually, I probably will put a little more spray on there so that we can be sure that we can peel it off without it sticking and making a puckered look in the top of the bread. And the top is really the important part. So we'll just place that over there. And then I'll do the same with the other. I'm gonna set them back in the same position I had them when they were rising earlier in the bowl. But now they're rising, getting ready to be baked. It will take about an hour this time. It's always speeds up a little bit when you rise it for the second time or the third time. So we'll wait about an hour on this, and then it's going to go into the oven, and it won't be long till this house is going to smell really good. I've removed the plastic from the top of these two loaves of bread, and you can see they have doubled in bulk, and it's been probably an hour and a half. I got busy and was doing something else, and I really would have put them in at an hour or an hour and 15 minutes, but I'm a little bit late, but this is kind of flexible. You can do that with this kind of bread. So these are going in the oven. They may take as long as 30 minutes, but I'll just keep testing them. I have a cake tester, which is very long. It's longer than a toothpick, and I'll just stick that in the deepest point, and if it comes out clean, then the bread is done. So I'll let you see the finished bread in a few minutes. Here are our two finished loaves of fresh baked bread. And I told you I was going to use a cake tester because it goes deeper, or it will handle deeper things. And when you go in, it comes back out clean as can be. So we know those are done. I have taken a knife and gone around the edge of each one, and hopefully that's enough. Actually, it shrank away from the side, so I think it's going to be fine anyway. What I'd like to do is to put them on a cooling rack. Actually, I took the rack out of my oven and washed it off, and I left it out while I was baking these because I wanted these to be at the center of the oven but have enough room to rise where they would not touch a rack. So I took the rack out and I can use it for cooling. So we're going to try to get one of these out. Let's go for this one. And this is very hot, but I'm going to turn it over in my hand. I think that's fine. Yeah, no problem. And that's what it looks like on the bottom. I'm going to place that on the rack to cool. And here goes the other one. Again, it's kind of hot, but it doesn't take long to turn these out if you have them loosened. And there's the bottom, nice and crusty and brown. And these smell delicious, I'll tell you that. So I'm going to go away and serve these up on a dish, and I'll come back and show them to you. Here's our wonderful fresh baked bread. And it just came out of the oven, so it's nice and hot and it melts that butter right away. And I'm serving it with butter. And here I have some green tea that I'm going to drink with it. So that's working on itself and getting ready. And I'm just gonna split this down the middle. Take a chunk that has a little butter, and test it. This is one of my favorite things in the world, this fresh baked bread. I don't eat a lot of bread. I've told a lot of you, don't eat a lot of pasta, bread, rice, potato chips, potatoes of any kind. I try to limit those things, but this is really something special. It's not often that we make bread because we don't want the calories. Obviously we eat sandwiches and we try to pick out things that are pretty healthy, but the white homemade bread is really good, but I will show you the whole wheat type sometime when I get around to it. Hope you like this recipe.